that there has also been delayed works. That is in Barara and in Tungamo. And in some instances, especially in Kabale, they say there is actually no work. There's been no work at all.
The revelation was made by Judith Nabakoba, the Minister of Lands, Housing and Urban Development, while appearing before Parliament's Physical Infrastructure Committee that is probing the progress of USMID project that started on 11th April 2019. Although all contractors were required to construct the roads within 1 year, many roads remain incomplete ahead of the looming 31st December 2023 project closure date.
Government, through the Minister of Finance, Planning and Economic Development, we requested the World Bank to extend the program closure date to December 31st, 2024, to allow the program complete all the ongoing works and meet the development objectives. This request for the 1 year extension was guided by the recommendation of the program midterm review, which observed that there was lost time of 12 months.
It should be recalled that government secured funding from the World Bank to a tune of $360 million, of which $335 million loan and a grant of $25 million, and currently the World Bank has released $325.56 million to government, leaving a balance of $18.7 million that is being processed and expected at the end of December 2023. However, by the end of September 2023, the program had utilized 834.38 billion shillings out of the 1.18 trillion shillings released.
Then the contractor had his own internal inefficiencies with regard to recruitment and retention of qualified personnel, project planning, cash flow management, and work resource management for the works. The contractor rarely has and adheres to an updated resourced work plan.
Minister Nabakoba admitted that the project has faced several challenges. Nabakoba noted that the assessment of the works in various districts has revealed that works valued at 224.5 billion shillings will not be completed by the program closure date, but shall be completed before the end of the current financial year, 2023-2024.
Extension then will let these contractors who are already on site continue with their work in that very 1 year. But you realize that even the works that are ongoing in refugee host districts, we can't complete by 31st.
Legislators asked the Ministry of Lands to increase their efforts in the supervision of his works if World Bank agrees to extend the project, and consider firing the current consultants if government is to register success of the project.
But the consultants, I was not happy with them, because they were in the same bed with the contractor. Really, I think all of you saw it, members, you saw it. They were in the same bed because they were not telling us, because the consultants are our people.
The USMID project is being implemented in the districts of Arua, Gulu, Lira, Soroti, Mbale, Jinja, Masaka, Fort Portal, and Hoima. Entebbe, Tororo, Kabale, Chitugumu, Kasese, Kamuli, Mubende, Lugazi, Apaj, Ntungamo, and Busia. The others include refugee hosting districts of Adjumani, Arua, Isinjiro, Kiriandongo, Moyo, Yumbe, Kamwenje, Lamo, Obonji, Telegu, and Madiokolo. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.